The Olympic Arts Festival?
Does John Huston draw a crowd at the film festival?
Is R.E.M. the critic's choice?
Would Conan be considered a swashbuckler?
Entertainment Tonight lives by the sword for Friday, the 6th of July, 1984.
I'm sorry, I just can't help you.
Hello again, everybody. I'm Mary Hart.
And I'm Ron Hendrick.
Coming up next, Angie Dickinson. She's mixing sex and politics in a new TV movie and hoping to come up with a winner.
And ahead, R.E.M., the rock group from Georgia, sets the music world on its ear. Last year, and seemingly from out of nowhere, a new band called R.E.M. became the darling of the rock press. However, critical praise does not guarantee record sales, so the initial success of their new single, South Central Rain, seems like an added blessing, a payoff almost, to the band's heavy tour schedule. Scott Osborne talked to Peter Buck, R.E.M.'s guitarist and spokesman.
The tree-lined streets of Athens, Georgia, seem the unlikely home to the most critically acclaimed rock band in years. In 1980, the four members of R.E.M. began playing in this abandoned church. Last year, the Village Voice picked their debut album over Michael Jackson's Thriller as Album of the Year. A rock critic called them the hippest rock band in the 80s. Despite all the attention, the band still calls Athens home.
The primary reason that our record got reviewed and noticed is because it was such an oddity to be from the South. Everyone up north really still kind of thinks that we all wear bib overalls and chew tobacco and, you know, and burn crosses on people's lawns all night long. And I think they were kind of surprised that we actually put out a record that didn't, you know, fall into the Southern stereotype.
Like many other Southern bands, they are music rebels. They don't buy into the homogenized sound they feel is prevalent today.
This last couple of years have been probably the most exciting years in rock and roll for me. But most of the music that I think is really good is really being ignored by everyone but, you know, a very small audience and the critics. So much of what's on the radio is pretty much bland, processed nothingness. I mean, every record sounds like it was made by the same five guys. You know, I mean, I can't tell half the bands apart.
While critics may love R.E.M., many concur with listeners who say the band's lyrics are too obscure. One joke had the group's album Murmur retitled Mumble. As guitarist Peter Buck says, their music is designed to be thought-provoking, not merely to serve as background.
Houston the mountain, the party call, the lines are down, the wise man build his words upon the rocks, but I'm not bound to follow suit.
We're not the most linear band in the world, but I think so much of rock and roll has become just, you know, easily digestible, that it's all right out front for you. You have a video that tells you what the song's about, and the lyrics, only an idiot could misconstrue them. And the music is something you've heard 8 million times. I don't think it's necessarily a bad thing for people to have to work a little bit harder at listening to a record and think about it.